enjoys nothing more than to show off his captivating rhythm while beating an opponent in humiliating fashion.
Here we go with Fandango. Fandango making a move. Squeezing down on the head. Looking to build momentum. Well, let's get your thoughts here on Fandango.
The sky's the limit. I see a lot of main events in the future.
He went up and went down. Look out.
We all know what goes up must come down.
That did not look good for Damian Sandow.
You know, I thought Sandow was smarter than to get taken down like that.
Damian Sandow knows how to polish off an opponent. Fandango's exciting entrance is just the beginning. As the ballroom dancer enters the arena with all the pomp and circumstance, pageantry and charisma, he feels the WWE audience can handle. When the bell rings, Fandango utilizes his fancy footwork and dances all over his opponents.
Cole, when Fandango's famous entrance song, Chuck-a-la-la, plays, the crowd leaps to his feet and sings along with WWE's resident ballroom dance expert. But when the match starts, Fandango's tactics are, well, let's just say, not appreciated by everyone.
Looking to fly.
Man, he takes to the air.
Wow.
Whoa, now that's a counter.
He's really putting his athleticism on display here. Fandango prides himself on everything he does in the ballroom and in the ring being a perfect 10. He fancies himself on being enticing to all who see him. And let's face facts, Fandango knows how to make an entrance and an exit. No one loves Fandango like Fandango.
Damian Sandow gets out of that one. Nice move.
Oh! And he missed that one. God, that's gotta hurt.
Yeah, you're not doing any damage with swings like that, but keep doing it. The breeze may give him a cold.
My God, his body's been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
Man, I hope we can get a doctor out here as a precaution. Damaged ribs like that can make it hard to breathe. One of the most popular dances on the planet is the Fandango. When Chuck-a-la-la hits, everyone starts Fandangoing. In the ring, Fandango's fancy footwork makes him wrestle circles around his opponents and infuriate fans. They love doing the dance, but they despise the man who created it. That's an enigma if I've ever seen one. Oh, that's sure. The shoulders are down. Reversal.
Nothing gentle about that landing.
Somebody's gonna get hurt in this match. Hey, that's
plenty of fight left.
You're right, this guy's still near 100%. Oh, that was close, but still not enough to keep Fandango down. I think it's safe to say that WWE has not been the same since Damian Sandow made his debut here in 2012. From that moment, Sandow's been one of the most denounced superstars on the roster. The guy refers to himself as the intellectual savior.
Fandango surprises him with a Russian leg sweep. This thing is over, folks.
Well, it was awesome.
It doesn't get much more exciting than the action we're seeing here tonight on Superstars. We're looking at complete domination here. King, you mentioned Sandow's debut in 2012, and I remember as one of the broadcasters of that match, you could hear people all over the arena firing verbal insults at him.
Yeah.
But to his credit, Damian Sandow has ignored his critics and amassed an impressive resume in WWE, including being Mr. Money in the Bank.
Well, Damian Sandow says that he wants to revitalize the WWE with a cultural refinement. I
think a lot of people want to refine his face. I know I do. Sandow's launched attacks on the likes of John Cena, Dolph Ziggler, Kofi Kingston, and even D-Generation X.
That wild strike found nothing but empty air that time.
Man, that's what you call swinging for the fences and missing.
You could call this a good old-fashioned butt-whooping.
Yeah, that's exactly what we're witnessing, a butt-whooping. Damian Sandow loves punishing those that he consider an ignoramus. Sandow's dangerous forms of attack include the face buster, body scissors, and knee strikes. And it doesn't end there. Damian Sandow will stay on the offensive until you can no longer compete.
You can see him struggling to stand after all the damage he's taken.
And he brings the action back inside the ring.
Yeah, I think this is good strategy.
Oh, wow. Boy, he's really done his homework for this match. How much damage did that do?
A lot from the looks of it.
We're looking at complete domination here. King, earlier you mentioned Damian Sandow's choice of offense. Sandow deals with the Russian leg sweep.
Oh, when you land hard from those, you're never the same.
Fandango wants to take a chance.
Oh, they're taking a risk.
Fandango.